Hello and welcome back. So this is the last video for section 9, and here I'm going to show you the last missing piece, namely how to find k for the k nearest neighbor method. We are going to use the same data set, so the waiting times for this old faithful geezer, but now k nearest neighbor, there is not a bandwidth to be chosen, but it's this integer number k which means how many neighbors do we average over. So it's a bit different, and it is more different because the method is different in character, and this time I don't know a good trick to speed up the calculation. So for the leaf one out estimate, what we are going to do, I'll show you in a second, we are just using the method as we have seen it in the naive way, and we just admit we have to compute n different estimates, leaving out each of the observations in turn, and then we just do that. It will probably be possible to do that faster by sorting the data once and then cleverly picking observations, but I can't see an easy way to do that, and we'll see it's not too slow to do it naively. Good, so let's get this done. I've already copied here the code for accessing the data, so we are going to use the old faithful geezer dataset again. And when we did k-nearest neighbor regression before, we used a library called fNN, which stands for fast nearest neighbor. And the function we used specifically was kNN regression, kNN.reg. And I think what we need to do is we need to plug in x in here, y as in an argument y, and then we set k. And with test, we can plug in a range of values where we want to evaluate the estimate. So let's define x tilde before. There, I've forgotten the range of x. Let me see. It was from 1.6 to 5.1. So say sequence maybe from 1 to 6, maybe in 500 steps. And then we can plug in x here, y equals y, k equals, where's the whole point of this is we don't know yet. So let's take 10. And test is x tilde. Let's see. That does not work. Why is this? I remember something that we need to do it like that, maybe. Yes, so it really likes data frames here, so that it can know the x and the x tilde refer to the same variable because they have now the same name in the data frame. Okay, so let's store that in a variable m, and then we can do plot x, y, and then the lines, well, x tilde we told it, and I think it's m pred for predicted. Good. Here is the k nearest neighbor estimate computed once. So the next thing we need to do is we need to run that in a loop, compute n different estimates so that we can get our leaf one out estimate. So what do we need to do? Well, first we need n. So n is the length of x. That's one way how we can define it. And then this code we do for I ranging from 1 to n. And what we need is we need to leave out the i's sample. So I do x minus I here and y minus I. Minus I in R means the vector with the I sample omitted. And that also changes. Namely, now we need to evaluate that only at the point xi. We can do it like that. And then we just need to store the result. So let's make a vector for the results. Say y pred for predicted y values is an empty vector of length n. And the ith element we can now set as m pred. I think I can write it like this because xi is a number, vector of length 1. So I assume m pred will be a vector of length 1 now, and that in R is exactly the same as the number, so I don't think we need to compare it or anything. Let's run that. That was satisfyingly fast, and y pred looks okay. Good, that looks rather reasonable. That is the predicted values at every data point location if we leave the point itself out of the estimate. I think that has worked, at least close to the regression line, not identical to the regression line. And it should not be identical because we left out the I sample and they have the right kind of locations. Okay, so I would think mean squared error is mean y minus y pred squared. I think that's the quantity we are going to minimize, and here we get a value of 34. That's certainly within the range of values we have seen in the previous section. Okay, so that's how we get the mean squared error for fixed k. K is fixed for 10. And now, as before, I write that in a function, MSE kNN maybe, the function of k, and I can use just the code I have here. And the only thing I need to do is, instead of 10, I plug in here the k coming from the argument. And we don't need to write MSE here, we can just return that thing, maybe by just writing it here. Good, so if we do that, and then we write MSE kNN 10, then hopefully we get back our 34.03621. That has worked, and we can also try 11 and 12. And that is quite fast still. Let me try to measure this, I think. Yes, that took 0.06 seconds to do that estimate, so that is certainly fast enough. We don't need to worry about doing anything clever. Okay, and now we can just copy the code which we used in the previous section, only here we are not varying h, but we are varying k. I've copied the old code here, let's just modify that. So instead of h, we have k, and that's integers. There is no way of doing a logarithmic range, although I don't know. Let's just do 1 to 60 or something, 1 to 100. Not sure whether that is fast enough. Then we do MSE, and now I created a bit of trouble for myself. I rename the function, then I can call the variable MSE kNN. I don't know. MSE kNN FN. Fn for function. Then again, we have only one here, MSE kNN, oh, and sequence along needs to be along k. MSE kNN I is, I should call that R. Let's do that. We call that R kNN to be in line with what we did before. So R kNN ki. I think that will do it. And we fix up the plot later. Maybe I can do it straight away. kNN. Good. And that, I anticipate, will now take a bit of time. So I put a bit of printing in here just that we are informed of what's going on. And I do my tick and talk again that we know afterwards how long it took. Good. Let's see. Object H not found. I must have overlooked. Oh, length H. Here, yeah, that is now length K. Oh, that's not too bad. I see the number scrolling past rather quickly. Though that took 5.132 seconds, and the printing command we haven't really thought about yet. I wrote kNN in lowercase here, and the range we don't need. That was for the previous plot where we had two lines in one plot. And now I accidentally rerun the whole thing rather than just redoing the plot. That looks right. Probably I should not have stopped at 100. Let's do that from 10 to 120. Oh, I saw a mistake in my output. Does not matter, but I should have written ki here rather than I. Good. 120 was also too large. So the optimum will be somewhere in this interval. I think we can now just pick out the optimum here using numbers. So best k is k which dot min MSE kNN, and then a vertical line at the best k. And the plot has a logarithmic axis, which makes maybe no sense here. So let's redo the plot. Here, the optimum seems to be below 40. Yeah, I can believe that that is the minimum. Also, the function looks quite flat. Maybe actually I started at 1 again, and then I fix it up here by doing ylim is from minimum of MSE kNN up to, I don't know, 36, something like that. That looks good. And we see the value of k does not really matter. Anything from 25 to 100 seems to be comparable with errors less than 33. If I remember right, in the previous section where we chose the bandwidth, I think the errors were always above 33. Whatever. Good, and that is our result. And that shows how we find the optimal value k using cross-validation for k nearest neighbor estimates. And just looking back at the code, so here you see that looks much more straightforward. There was not much I needed to explain on special things we do. We just did it how it was defined. We compute the estimate leaving out observation I, use that to evaluate it at the site I, then compare to the given data at site I, square it, and sum it up or average it. So that was more straightforward. The price was it took now 6 seconds, where in the previous section it didn't show you, but I'm telling you now it was nearly instantaneous to get the estimates. Good. So that is all I wanted to tell you about here. And that's also the end of this module. So here the only thing left for me is to say goodbye. So bye-bye everybody, and hopefully see you soon somewhere.